The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 8th Chapter, Text Number 32, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 12, 1974, in Mayapur, India.
Some say that the unborn is born for the glorification of pious kings, and others say that he is born to please King Yadu, one of your dearest devotees. You appear in his family as sandalwood appears in the Malaya hills.
Kitidahu rajangajatam punna sloka sakitae jada priyasa annavai malayasa eva chandanam. So Krishna has nothing to do. He is the supreme. Why he shall have something to do? Natasya karjam karanam. This is the definition in the Vedas. God has nothing to do. He is self-sufficient. Neither he has got any aspiration. Just like we are thinking of purchasing this land, that land. Why Krishna will think like that? Because every land is belonging to him. So he has nothing to purchase. Everything is there. So why he comes? That is the same way as Krishna says personally. He comes for Pritranaya sanutam sadhunam vinashaya duskita. He wants to give protection to the devotees, to glorify the devotees. That is his business. Otherwise he has no business. He has nothing to do. Just like a devotee has nothing to do except serving Krishna, except to see Krishna is pleased. Similarly, Krishna has nothing to do, but he wants to glorify his devotee. This is reciprocation. Jijathamang prapadyante. If you dedicate your life for glorifying the Supreme Lord, the Lord is also ready. His business is to glorify you. Otherwise he has no business. Therefore here it is said that priyas, jada priyas. King Yadu became very dear to Krishna by rendering service. Priyas, as Krishna is very dear to the devotee, similarly, devotees are also very, very dear to Krishna. There is another verse. Sapadamulanga bhajata priyas. Sapadamulanga bhajata priyas. If one is engaged at the lotus feet of Krishna, he becomes very, very dear. Sapadamulanga bhajata priyas. Bhajata. One who is simply engaged for rendering service to the lotus feet of Krishna, he has no other business. He becomes priya. And as soon as you become priya or dear to Krishna, then your all problems solved. Just like if you become a dear child of a very big rich man, then what is your problem? Automatically. He's taken care of. Because he has become dear child of a very big man, so what is his problem? No problem. Similarly, we have to become very dear to Krishna. Then all our problems solved. These rascals, kurmis, they do not know. They want to become happy by their own endeavor. That is called kurmi. They are working very hard, the same thing, to be very happy. And the devotee is also trying to become happy. Everyone is trying. Sukham matam tikam jatat tat atindriya grahyam. Everyone is trying to become happy, because to become happy is our natural tendency. Anandamaya vyasat. Everyone is trying to become happy. But the kormis, the gyanis, the yogis, they do not know how to become perfectly happy. That making their own endeavor. Kormis are trying to work hard day and night to get money, somewhere or other, never mind black and white, bring money. I must have nice car, nice house, nice bank balance. This is kormi. And jnani, when he is fed up with working, when he understands that this working hard and bank balance could not make me any way happy, so therefore this is false. All these activities, what are the brahma satta, jagan mithya. Become disgusted and take to brahma, brahma satta. But brahma satta is fair. But because they are trying to understand brahma by their speculative method, they cannot understand brahma. Athapiti deva padambujadayam prasadalesanu grihita eva hi janati tattam. You can understand the supreme brahma. Simply understanding brahma will not give you satisfaction. Simply understand aham brahmasmi. This will not. Suppose if you have got money and you are aware that you are very rich man, simply thinking that you are very rich man and you see your money in the treasury, you will be happy? No. When the money is utilized in so many ways for your gratification, then you are happy. Similarly, simple understanding aham brahmasmi, this realization will not make you happy. You have to utilize his brahma's position. That means bhakti. This is called shantaras. Simply to understand aham brahmasmi, this is called shantaras. You must develop further. That is called dasaras. To become the servant of the supreme brahma, then further advance. Simply to understand that I am brahma will not give you. Just the same example, it is very easy that if you simply understand you have got much money, just like we are trying to purchase land. But purchase land means I must have money. The money is there. So why am I not happy? Why am I trying to purchase land? To utilize the money. That is equal. Every businessman has got money, enough money. But why they are active in the business circle, they are going to the market, share market, this market, utilize the money. The same thing, simply to understand that aham brahmasmi. Therefore they fail. All these so-called sannyasis, simply understanding aham brahmasmi, I have become now Narayan, not giving them satisfaction. But because they have no information about rendering service to the Parabrahma, they come to again to this material field to render service, to open a hospital, to open a school, to feed the Daridra Narayan. In this way they image, because they want activities. So Brahma realization without activity of Brahma will not allow you to stay in the Brahma position. You will fall down. Arujya kritchena parang padang tata patanti adha anadita jasmatangaya. Patanti adha, by great austerities and penance, they can rise up to the Parampadam, Aham Brahmasmi, Brahmapad. But Arujya Kritchena Parampadam, Tata, from that place, Patanti Adha, again falls down in this material world. Why? Anadhita Jusmadangaya. Because they did not learn how to honor your lotus feet. Because they are impersonalists. They are God, or the Brahma has no leg. And so how they will take shelter of the leg or lotus feet? Impersonal. Therefore the very word is used. Anadhita Jusmat Angraya. Angraya means this leg, lotus feet. So because they have no information, or even they have got information, they are not inclined to render service, therefore they fall down. This is the position. So, our business is not to realize simply that I am Aham Brahmasmi. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Bhuta Prasannat. When you understand that you are not this body, but you are spirit soul, then actually if you realize, then if I understand, na jayate na mriyate va, the soul does not die. Then here the kurmis are working very hard because he is upset that if I do not work hard, if I do not get money, then I shall die out of starvation. But if you are actually Brahma realized, if you understand that I will not die, then where is your activities? You will not die. If somebody, some physician gives you a tablet, now you take this tablet, you will not die. Then you will stop working immediately, because I will not die. So Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma, that is all right. Now I am spirit soul, I understand I will never die. That is Prasannatma. Nasuchati Nakankhati, there is no need of lamentation. Samas Sarveshu Bhutesh. But Mad Bhakti Labhate Param, if you do not take to devotional service, simply by realizing that you are Brahma, will not help. And by devotional service, you can become deer. Just like Arjuna is addressed by Krishna, Bhaktosi Priyosi. You are my devotee and very dear friend. So our business is somehow or other to become very dear to Krishna as a servant, as a friend, or as father and mother, or as lover, somewhere or other, you become, you make Krishna your dear as master, or as son, or as father, or father they are doing everyone. Even ordinary person, if he is God conscious, he takes Krishna as supreme father, just like the Christian, they take that, oh, Father, give us our day. Father means to ask, give me, give me, give me, give me. Nobody wants to give Father, but wants to take from Father. Sometimes our students, when they spend extravagantly, and I point out, he says, my Father has sent money. Sometimes. My Father has sent money. Why did you stay at Ashoka Hotel? My father sent money. Why not ask your father to send money? Why you are collecting by making life members? So, my idea of father. Father means that whenever I want to stay in Ashoka Hotel, he will send money. Not that I will send money to father, he may stay at Ashoka. Nobody thinks like this. Father may send money and I shall stay in Ashoka. This is the idea of father. Father means to exploit him. To exploit. So, the father conception of God, mother conception of God, is not bad. Just like in Bengal especially, they have got mother conception. Mother conception means the same thing, to exploit, take from mother or father. But the Vaishnava conception is not to accept God as father or mother, but as son. Son means to give. Father means to take from him, and son means to take from the father. So if you become father of God, then your business will be to give, not to take. That is Vaishnava. From the very beginning of the son's life, the mother is giving service to the son, the father is giving service. So therefore, the service is there. Even Krishna is afraid of mother Yashoda. Oh, why? Why mother Yashoda was trying to bind Krishna? Because he disrupted the process of service of mother Yashoda to Krishna. That is, mother Yashoda tried that you have broken the butter and you have distributed to the monkeys, you rascal, then how you will live? I kept the butter for you so that you will eat and you will become fatty. And you have broken that and you have distributed the butter to the monkeys, so you must be punished. So the aim is to serve Krishna. Not that Yashoda is thinking, my butter is spoiled by this child, therefore he should be punished. He is anxious to see that Krishna may not starve for want of butter. His child does not know he has distributed the butter to the monkeys. But Krishna knows that these monkeys are not ordinary monkeys. Those monkeys, they have taken birth in Vrindavan and come to Krishna. Do you think they are ordinary ones? The devotees that playing as monkey for Krishna's satisfaction. These are the intricate meanings of understanding Krishna's leela. Therefore Krishna says, janma karma me divvam jujana atitattva. So understand Krishna leela. Therefore we have to understand Krishna leela, Krishna, from this book, Bhagavad Gita, but not direct. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommends Bhagavad Gita Paro Bhagavat Sthane. Just try to understand Bhagavat or Bhagavan from the realized soul, not from the professional man. So, yeah, kechidahu rajanga jatam ahu ajam jatam. Contradiction. Now, Krishna says, ajopi, although I am birthless, I do not take birth. Ajopi son, abhyatma, bhutanam isharopi son. He is the supreme being. He is the master of everyone, and he never takes birth. Still, he takes birth. The contradiction. He never takes birth. Ajo, at the same time, ajopi. Here it is said, kechidahu ajam. God or Krishna is ajo. He never takes birth. But again, he says jatam. He has taken birth. These contradictions should be understood. The Vedas, there are many such contradictions. Pashati, achakhu. Krishna, God sees, but he has no eyes. Similarly, God, Krishna, takes his birth, although he never takes birth. These are contradictions. Pashyati achakhu apani pada javanak grahita. He has no leg, but he goes so fast, nobody can compete. These are Vedic statements, you will find in the Upanishad. Apani pada, he has no leg, he has no hand. A javanak grahita, but if you offer him something, he takes. Krishna says, it is not my word. Patram pushpam phalam toyam jomi bhaktya prajacchati tadaham asnami bhaktya upritam. Now, if the Supreme Lord, God, has no hand, no leg, then how he can walk? Just like Sakhi Gopal. Sakhi Gopal, he was deity, apparently showing as made of stone. And the devotee is asking, my Lord Gopal, you have to come to give witness. Gopal was smiling and said, how you expect a deity can walk, that I shall go to give witness for you. The bhakta said, if the deity can speak and smile, he can walk also. That is the conviction of devotee. And the other party, they agreed that if Gopal comes to give witness, my sister will be given to you. He, because he's atheist, he is thinking that how the deity will come. If he'll never come, then I shall not have to fulfill my promise. He was confident like that. That is the difference between a devotee and non-devotee. The non-devotee cannot understand. They will take it that once you say that God has no eyes, then how he can see? God has no leg, then how can he walk? God has no hand, then how can he accept your offering? Therefore, the conclusion should be that ajopi, although Krishna never takes birth, and again he takes birth, he has taken birth, therefore his birth is not like our birth. This is the conclusion. He has no birth, but he has taken birth. Therefore, an intelligent man will conclude that his birth is not like our birth. Therefore, Krishna says, janma karma me divvam. It is all transcendental. It is not this ordinary birth. Ordinary birth means male and female union, then there is pregnancy, then the child comes out of the womb. It is not like that. It is, we can take this example, just like the sunrise in the morning, udila aruna purava bhage. Before the sunrise, the sky becomes reddish, and then the sun comes out. So if somebody says that the eastern side is the birthplace of sun, is it a fact? No. The sun is always there in the sky, but with your limited eyes you are seeing that now is Saminka, sunrise. Sun does not rise, not set. Sun is already there. Your imperfect eyes, you see there is sunrise, there is sunset. Is it not a fact? Similarly, Krishna is always there. But because we do not know Krishna, therefore, we understand that Krishna is taking birth from Devaki, or Krishna has taken birth in the family of the Jodhus. Yes, he appears like that he has taken birth in the Jodhu family. Because why? The purpose is to glorify the family because it belongs to the devotee, Maharaj. That is his purpose. His real purpose is that the Jodhu dynasty, Maharaj Jodhu was a great devotee. Yada Jodha Priyasha, he appears to take birth in the family of Maharaj Yadu, just like Lord Ramchandra. He took birth in the family of Maharaj Raghu. Therefore, Lord Ramchandra is called Raghunath, Dasarathi. As Krishna is called Vasudev, because he accepted Vasudev as his father. So, actually, Krishna has no birth. Krishna doesn't require. He can appear in any family. He, just like Krishna appeared, Matsavata, in the family of fish. Keshavadhita meena sarira, jaya jagadish. Krishna took birth as a pig. Keshavadhita varaha sarira, jaya jagadish. Krishna is free. He can appear anywhere, everywhere. That's like Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhesa arjuna tishtati. He is situated in everyone's heart. So he is with everyone, every living being has got Krishna. So Krishna is already there in the heart. From the heart he appears in front, just like Dhruva Maharaj. He was meditating that Vishnu form of Krishna, and all of a sudden he saw that Vishnu is not there. Then he opened his eyes, he saw Vishnu is in front. So what is the difficulty for Krishna? If he is within the heart and he becomes in your front, is it very difficult task for him? But the rascals, atheists, they cannot understand. Krishna is everywhere. That is explained here. Jadap priyasya annavaya. He can appear. How it is? Malayaseva chandanam. The sandalwood is famous as produced in Malaysia or Malayas. I think formerly they used to grow sandalwood in Malaysia. What is the capital? Kuala Lumpur. Yes, we had been in Kuala Lumpur. Now instead of sandalwood, they are growing rubber. Yes. Formerly, Malay chandan, Malayas, Malayan chandan, sandalwood was very famous. Still it is famous. So, this chandan tree can grow anywhere. But it is famous as Malayan chandan. Similarly, Krishna can appear from anywhere. He is independent. But he appeared as this descendant of the Jadu dynasty. Why? Jadap priyasya. Punna slokasya kirtaye. Those who are devotee, they are punna sloka. Or Krishna is also punna sloka, uttama sloka. Krishna janadanne. As Krishna is known as Uttama Sloka, similarly the devotees are called Punna Sloka. How they become Punna Sloka? Simply by hearing about Krishna. Sinnathang Sakatha Krishna, Punna Sloka Kirtan. Anyone who is always in contact with Krishna, he is Punna Sloka, and Krishna is Uttama Sloka. Uttama sloke bhagavati bhakti bhavati naishti. So these are the terms used in the Shastra. As Krishna is uttama sloka, similarly a devotee is punna sloka. As the devotee worships Krishna with selected poems, uttama sloka, they are not ordinary poems. Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalpa vrikha lakha vritesu suravi ravi. These are not ordinary verses. These are transcendental verses. Govinda madhi purusam tamahang bhajam. So Krishna is worshipped by transcendental verses, transcendental language, Vedic language, that is transcendental language. That's what is called uttama sloka. So punna sloka, when is advanced, he can worship the uttama sloka. नष्ट प्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवा नित्यं डेली रेगुलर सो एज यू आर डेली हियरिंग श्रीमद् भागवतम इफ यू गो ऑन देन नष्ट प्राय एवरीथिंग ऑल डर्टी थिंग्स विद इन योर हार्ट चित्त दर्पण मार्जनम इट विल बी ऑल क्लीन देन यू बिकम पुण्यश्लोक नित्यंग भागवत सेवा सिन्नतांग सगता कृष्ण नित्यंग पुण्यश्लोक अपी सिंपली बाय हियरिंग सो वी आर इनवाइटिंग एवरीवन टू बिकम पुण्यश्लोक सिंपली बाय हियरिंग श्रीमद् भागवत देर इज नो कम हियर टेक प्रसादम चांट हरे कृष्ण डांस इन जुबिलेशन बिकम पुण्यश्लोक And Krishna, you become very dear to Krishna. This is Parvachana Raya. Thank you very much.